Now, I would say it is we have seen all cases. Now you should be able to solve every homogeneous equation. Let's go back to the non-homogeneous equation. By starting from the second order equation, it is not important to write equations of higher order because the logic is always the same. The higher order has been important to see a I have considered also higher order because, for example, in the first exercise, I wanted to show you the independence between the cases of lambda. One gives the first exponential, negative one half gives the second exponential. The couple of complex conjugate solutions gives the couple of goniometric solutions, real exponential times sine, real exponential times cosine. The real exponential takes the real part of the complex conjugate solution times x. Sine and cosine of the same argument x. The coefficient in which the coefficient is the imaginary part. Okay, this is the general rule. When we have multiple solutions, we write the same exponential, but then one is left as exponential only. The others are multiplied by x squared, by x cubed, if we would have highest algebraic multiplicities. Okay, now we know all. Let's consider again the non-homogeneous equation. Let's consider, for example, let's see, 2y second. 2y second plus 7y prime plus 3y equal, let's write here, until now we have solved only homogeneous equations. About the homogeneous equation, you should now know, you should know all. Any case could be solved by you easily at this point. Now, let's consider again, as the first time, a non-homogeneous equation in which the right-hand side is not zero, but another given function. Okay. I write here E2, for example, E2 negative 3x. I recall you and remember you that we have three cases. Case one, polynomial of degree n. Second case, exponential of this kind, e2 ax plus b, exponential with the exponent of first degree, 3 sine of ax plus b, o sine or cosine of ax plus b, that is sine or cosine with whose argument is a polynomial of first degree. When we find as function in the right hand side one of these three functions, or if you want, no, sine and cosine must be, sorry, I rewrite here, one, polynomial of order n. Second case, exponential with the exponent or with the exponent polynomial of first degree. Third case, sine of ax plus b and or cosine of ax plus b. When we find one of these three functions or every any combination of them, addition, multiplication, additional multiplication, when you find such a function in the right hand side, I recall all ab initio from the beginning. That is, in this case, the solution has the structure, as we discussed the first day last Monday. Homogeneous solution y of x when the right hand side is zero plus y particular. This is the form of the solution. Okay, y zero, the solution of the homogeneous equation associated to this equation. Now is known, should be known, because we have done several exercises of many orders. The problem is now to find the particular solution, YP. Well, I was saying, when the right-hand side is one of these three functions, or their combination means addition or multiplication, in this case, y particular is of the same form of the function in the right hand side. And you don't need to apply, it is not necessary to apply the general method. Okay? There is a little exception, but the exception, problem that could arise is solved with the same procedure with which we have made different these equal exponentials. Here I recall you, we found three equal solutions of the algebraic equation, that is the solution negative 2 having algebraic multiplicity 3, like the exponent. Okay, we have written at the beginning, we write exponential, but since they are equal, they are made different by multiplication by x squared, x cubed, and so on, depending on the algebraic multiplies. Okay, this procedure to distinguish, to make different linearly dependent terms is the same here. The same procedure will be applied here when we find linearly dependent terms. The condition must be that every term of the we write all terms of the homogeneous solution, all terms of the particular solution, but no term of the homogeneous solution must be similar to no term of the particular solution, and vice versa. Okay, if we find two linearly dependent terms in the homogeneous solution and in the particular solution, we make them linearly independent with the same procedure of before. Now we see what it means. Well, first of all, we associate the homogeneous equation. 2y second plus 7y prime plus 3y equals 0, to which we associate the algebraic equation. 2 lambda squared plus 7 lambda plus 3 equals 0. Pay attention also at the exam. Lambda must be the same, the exponent, like the order. If one derivative is absent, here we have no lambda corresponding. Pay always attention. Well, we solve this equation by the formula lambda equal negative 7 plus minus square root of 49 7 square minus 4 times 2 is 8 times 3 is 24 over 4 to 8 4 equal 49 minus 24 is 26. 25. 49 minus 24 is 25. Square root is 5. All the square root is 5. Negative 7 plus 5 is negative 2 over 4, negative 1 half. Negative 7 minus 5 is negative 12 over 4, negative 3. Okay, now we write the solution. I write directly y of x. Y of x equals homogeneous solution. Now you are brave to write directly the homogeneous solution. Exponential of negative 1 half x. Exponential of negative 3x. And then I write their linear combination. Capital A plus B. This is y0 of x. Let's write an unuseful bracket. Plus particular solution. What is the particular solution? I recognize here one of these three functions, three categories. I write sine and cosine together for the reason that will be appear later. These are together. Now they are not involved because we have only the exponent. We recognize one of these three functions, in particular the second function, and then we copy. The particular solution is the same function, the same exponential, multiplied by another coefficient. Let's write here five exponentials. I have changed the coefficient. The right hand side is five an exponential with the exponent of first degree. Since this function belongs to this category, the second category, I add directly, without a general method, the same function, the same kind of function, that is e to negative 3x times another coefficient, not 5, another coefficient which could be called h. I don't use a because a capital A, small a, but they could be confused. Well, this is the particular solution. But now it is straightforward to notice that these two terms, a term of the homogeneous solution and a term, the unit term of the particular solution, are linearly dependent. Do you see? They are linearly dependent. And then, how can we make them linearly independent? The homogeneous solution cannot be absolutely changed. Only the particular solution can be changed. That is, this is wrong, I write y of x equal a e to negative 1 half x plus b e to negative 3 x homogeneous solution plus h e to negative 3 x in order to make these two terms linearly independent, all the whole particular solution must be multiplied by x. Is it clear? This is the particular solution. Y0YP. Okay? The differential equation is linear. That is, I recall you, there we have the linear differential operator L equal 2 second derivative plus 7 first derivative plus 3 times L of y0 of x is 0, because if we let act L on the first exponential and if we let act L on e to negative 1 half x or separately e to negative 3 x, you must always do the verifications to become familiar with this concept. L of y0 is 0. It is the solution of the homogeneous equation. Okay? L of yp equal to 5 e to negative 3x. And then this is the, sorry, we have L of y0 equals 0 for all a, b. L of yp equals 0 only for particular h. A and b are arbitrary constants because the equation is of second order. H must be computed by imposing L of yp of x not equal to zero, but the particular solution must give the function, do you remember the vectors, the linear algebra, must give 5 e to negative 3x, but for particular h, and then h must be computed such that L of yp is equal to 5 exponential of negative 3x. Okay? This particular solution does not give always the right hand side, but only for a particular value of h that we now find. Well, we take yp of x equal hx times the exponential. In order to substitute this particular solution into the differential equation, the original differential equation, we must compute first derivative, second derivative. And then y prime p of x equal h times 1 times exponential without derivative plus vice versa negative minus 3 h x exponential second derivative, this time without using Leibniz rule. Well, here we have negative 3h exponential. 1 term only, because it is not a product. From here we get 2 terms. we derive x and we take and we get minus 3h exponential only. Now we derive the exponential, which gives times negative 3, and then plus 9 hx without derivative exponential. Now we substitute 2y second, that is 9hx exponential minus 6, okay, minus 6 exponential. This is 2y second plus 7y prime, these two terms, negative, I write before x, negative 3hx exponential plus h exponential plus 3y. 3y is hx exponential. This must be equal to 5 exponential. Okay? We can simplify exponential. They are all equal. Do you recognize them? I don't apply to the simplification, but we know. Another observation. All terms of the form x exponential cancel out magically. 18h, I don't say the exponential because the exponential is common. 18hx minus 21hx plus 3hx equals 0. 18 plus 3 is 21, minus 21 is 0. Question for you. Is it surprising that it is 0? The answer is no. Why? Because these terms, I underline them. The terms with x, with the factor x, are all terms in which only the exponential is derivative. Okay. If we write what you want, the exponential times what you want, hx, what you want. If here I have exponential times hx, all terms in which we have hx are terms in which only the exponential is derivative. Okay, only the exponential. Well, but if we derivate only the exponential by holding what is before as a coefficient, this is as tau we are derivating the exponential only. But the exponential e to negative 3x only with its first derivative, second derivative, is like the derivatives of this exponential e to negative 3x. Okay, but this exponential e to negative 3x alone, we already know that it gives zero because it is solution of the homogeneous equation. Okay. When we have hx, it is as tau, we consider hx like a coefficient. and we derivate only the exponential. That is, it is as though we are considering, for example, HH exponential, as though we are taking HX is considered a coefficient, capital C, for example, exponential, okay? But this function gives a zero because it is solution of the homogeneous equation. It is solution of this. And then it is not surprising that this cancellation, if you want, is equivalent to say that we are verifying the homogeneous equation. This cancellation, this simplification, is equivalent to the verification of the homogeneous equation with the solution, the exponential. Okay? Well, the other terms are 1, 2, that is, sorry, here I have forgotten, 9 HX exponential minus 6 H exponential, I have forgotten H here inside, here in the middle. Well, we have now negative 12 H exponential. Plus 7 H exponential. I have forgotten H exponential. This must be equal to, This must be equal to 5 E to negative 3X. This is the equation for H. I recall you, I remember you that we must compute H. Now, this becomes negative 5 H exponential equal 5 exponential. And then this is, if you want, negative 5 H minus 5 times the exponential equals 0. What is the condition for the left hand side to be zero? That negative 5h minus 5 to be zero. That is h equal negative 1. Finished. Now we have found, we can write the solution. Y of X equal capital A E to negative 1 half X plus B E to negative 3 X homogeneous solution plus H, that is minus 1 X E to negative 3 X. This is the particular solution. This is the solution of the given equation. The given equation here. Okay. They are very simple, the differential equation. Let's do another exercise of this other kind. I write y second of x plus 8y prime of x plus 16y of x.
Excuse me, sir, can you
please?
Excuse me, sir, can you repeat the last question? Yeah, this one. Yes.
Before
the last one,
we had this equation, this non-homogeneous equation. We have solved the homogeneous equation 2y second plus 7y prime plus 3y equals 0. Algebraic equation, the two solutions by the formula, negative 1/2, negative 3. And then I write the homogeneous solution. Plus the same exponential in which I change only the coefficient only. But since these two terms are linearly dependent, I must make them linearly independent by multiplying the particular, the whole particular solution by x, because the homogeneous solution cannot be changed anymore. Okay, now this is the particular solution, and we have computed yp, I have copied yp of x, yp prime, yp second, I have inserted into the equation equal 5 exponential, all terms of the form x exponential, x exponential, cancel out, and we have discussed that this is not surprising. What remains it is negative 12h exponential plus 7h exponential equal 5 exponential. Here we write the exponential in evidence. We do the sum because they are similar. Negative 5h exponential, negative 3x, sorry, equal 5 exponential e to negative 3x. Now I write the equality, negative 5h equal 5, because they are both are multiplied by the same exponential, that is h equal negative 1. Okay, and then I come back here and I rewrite the solution, capital A e to negative 1 half x plus B e to negative 3x plus h, that is negative 1 minus x exponential. Ah, just a moment. Let's imagine to have the equation. I copy the equation 2y second plus 7y prime plus 3y equal 5 exponential plus 3y equal 5 exponential. Let's suppose to add the initial conditions y of 0 equal 1, y prime of 0 equal negative 4. That is, what are, this means, what are, what is the unique solution among these infinitely many solutions for every A and B? What is the unique solution satisfying also these initial conditions? Now, here we have y. We must compute y prime, because here we have y prime. Y prime of x is negative 1/2 a over 2 exponential, minus 3 b exponential. Okay? Here the product, minus exponential plus 3x exponential. And now we impose y of 0, this is y. If I substitute, if I put x equals 0, we have capital A times 1 e to 0 is 1. So y of 0 equal 3. Too many 1. Y of 0 is a times 1, a, plus b times 1, b. plus 0, because x equals 0, 0 times exponential is 0. A plus B equal, equal 3. This is A plus B, must be equal to 3. Y prime of 0 is negative A over 2. Negative 1 half x. Negative A over 2 times 1 minus 3B times 1. Minus 1, I am substituting x equals 0 here, the condition. Minus 1 plus 0, because here x is multiplied. This is y prime of 0, which must be equal to negative 4. Sorry, negative 8. I write. Otherwise, here becomes negative 3, too many numbers equal number. Negative 8. Now, this is a system. A plus B equal 3. Here, I multiply by 2 and change the signs. A plus 6b. Here we have negative 8 plus 1 is negative 7. Negative 7. I change the sign is 7. Multiplied by 2 is 14. Okay. Now we solve the system. We subtract the second equation minus the first equation. From below minus above, A minus A is 0. 6 minus 1 is 5B equal. 14 minus 3 is 11. From which we get B equal 11 over 5. A is 3 minus B. 3 is 15 over 5. This is 3. Minus B, minus 11 over 5, equal 4 over 15 minus 11 is 4 over 5. A is 4 over 5, B is 11 over 5. And then we can write the solution at the end. Y of X equal A e to negative 1 half x, but A is 4 over 5 e to negative 1 half x plus B plus 11 over 5 e to minus 3x minus x exponential. I leave to you as an exercise to verify that this function is the unique function satisfying the differential equation, non-homogeneous equation, and the boundary, the initial conditions. That is, you compute the first derivative and we verify that if we put x equals 0, we get the exponentials are 1, 1, and then we have 0, 0 times 0. We have 4 over 5 plus 11 over 5 is 15 over 5, that is 3. Then you compute the first derivative. Y prime of x is equal to negative 4 over 10 e to negative 1 half x minus 33 over 5 e to negative 3x minus e to negative 3x plus 3x e to negative 3x. This is the first derivative. If we put x equals 0, we get 1, 1, that is negative 2 over 5 minus 33 over 5, minus 1, and this is 0 because we have x times. Okay, equal. Negative 2 minus 33 is negative 35 over 5, minus 1, equal. Negative 7 minus 1 is negative 8. Okay? Is it clear what the Cauchy problem is? First of all, we solve the differential equation and we get this solution. And then to this solution, we impose this condition. Well, let's do the last equation. Y second of x, other two equations, plus 8y prime of x plus 16y equal, for example, equal 3e to negative 4x. Let's solve this equation with the boundary condition. Y of 0 equal y prime of 0 equal, we write equal later. First of all, we must solve the differential equation first, and then on the solution we must impose the boundary, the initial condition. But first of all, we must solve the equation. We associate the homogeneous equation equals 0, and then the algebraic equation lambda square plus 8 lambda plus 16 equals 0. Either you use the formula or you recognize that this is lambda plus 4 square equals 0, and then you get lambda equal negative 4, negative 4, negative 4 with algebraic multiplicity 2. Well, the solution is then written. Y of x equal e to minus 4x, e to minus 4x, but this is equal, and then we multiply one solution by x, and then we take their linear combination. This is the homogeneous solution of the homogeneous equation. Plus, pay attention. Here we have one of the exponential, that is one of these three functions. Okay? And then we add plus the same exponential times another coefficient. H exponential. Okay? But at this point, we observe that this function is similar to the solution. Is similar means is linearly dependent, they are linearly dependent. And then the homogeneous solution cannot be changed anymore. This must be clear. The homogeneous solution cannot be modified in any way, in no way. Only the particular solution can be modified. Modified in such a way that all terms of the particular solution are linearly independent with all terms of the homogeneous solution. And then we multiply times x. But now, if before the exponential only was linearly dependent with the first exponential, if we multiply by x, This is linearly dependent with the second exponential of the homogeneous solution. And then we must multiply by another x, that is x squared. Is it clear? This is the particular solution. And the particular solution must give 3, but it gives 3 only for a particular value of h. While, whereas the homogeneous solution is solution of this equation, of this homogeneous equation, for every arbitrary a and b, the particular solution gives the right hand side only for a particular value of h, as before. And then we must compute the first and the second derivative for the insertion. This is why p, y prime p of x is 2hx times the exponential minus 4hx squared without derivative times the exponential. This is y prime. What is y second? Y second p of x equal 2h times 1 times the exponential. Now I derivate the exponential. Negative 4 times 2 minus 8 h x without derivative exponential. Here I derive x squared minus 2 times 8, 2 times 4 is 8, minus 8 h x exponential plus 4 times 4, 16, h x squared exponential. These two terms can be summed. Well, let's substitute into the equation. We have y second. I copy y second. 16h x squared e to negative 4x minus 16h x exponential plus 2h exponential. This is yp second. Here plus 8 plus 8 y prime. What is y prime? This one, negative 4h x squared e to minus 4x plus 2h x e to negative 4x. This is yp prime of x. 8y prime, 8y prime, plus 16y. What is y? This is yp. Y prime, y second. This is y. H x squared, e to minus 4x. This is what yp gives when it is inserted to the left-hand side of the equation, equal 3 exponential, 3 e to negative 4x. Now, all terms with x squared and x can be, will cancel out. Let's verify. 16h x squared plus 16h x squared is 32 x squared minus 32, 8 times 4 times negative 4. And then these cancel out. Okay. Now, all terms with x are negative 16 hx plus 16 hx. Cancel out. Is it surprising? The answer is not, because all terms with x squared have only the derivatives of the exponential, but then the exponential is solution of the homogeneous equation. All terms with x exponential 1, 2 are the terms can be considered as the derivatives of the terms of the terms of the term x exponential in the homogeneous solution, and then they must give zero, because also x exponential is solution of the homogeneous equation. Okay, this is the logic. Now we have obtained only 2h. Simplified. It's only 2h e to negative 4x survives, equal 3 exponential. That is, either I write all in the left hand side with the exponential in evidence, or I cancel the exponentials. 2h equal 3, h equal 3 alpha. This is the only particular h. Now I rewrite the solution. Y of x final is a capital A e to negative 4x plus b x e to negative 4x. This is y0 of x plus h, that is plus 3 alpha x square e to negative 4x. This is the particular solution. L of y0 equals 0. L of yp, that is 3 alpha x square e to negative 4x, equal the right hand side, 3 e to negative 4x. Okay, it works so. Let me solve the last equation. For example, I write, pay attention, y 3y second plus 4y prime equal 5x plus 7. Let's solve this equation. What must we do? We associate 3 lambda square plus 4 lambda to 1 of the 1 of the 1. We have not lambda, the zeroth derivative. The function is the derivative of order 0. And then we have no constant. Okay? This is lambda square, lambda to 1, lambda 0. But lambda to 0 corresponds to the function, to the derivative of order 0. But we have not the derivative of order 0, because the coefficient is 0, if it does not appear. And then 3 lambda squared plus 4 lambda equals 0. This is solved by writing in evidence lambda times 3 lambda plus 4 equals 0. Without using the formula, lambda equals 0 lambda equal negative 4 over 3. And then we write y of x equal homogeneous solution e to 0x e to negative 4 over 3x and their linear combination. This is y0 of x plus. This is a polynomial that is, it belongs to these categories. And then we write the same polynomial of first degree. A, or no, hx plus k. But now we observe that these two terms are linearly dependent, because e to 0x is 1. This is only a. A and k are linearly dependent because they are similar, they are two constant. They can, this k can be summed to capital A. Okay? I must have all terms linearly independent. We cannot have any similarity. What must I do? We multiply the whole particular solution by x times x, x squared, x. Now we have no similarity more. Okay? Now I want to solve this equation. I am solving this equation. I must insert the first derivative, the second derivative here. But before, we must compute the derivatives of yp. Yp prime of x equal 2hx plus k. Yp second of x equal second degree, first degree. The derivative is the coefficient of x, 2h. And now we insert here. Y second is 2h plus 8. Y prime of x. Y prime is this one. 2hx plus k plus 16y. What is y? Y is, sorry, y is h x squared. Sorry, this is just a moment, all these sheets. Sorry, we are solving this equation, the separation here and of before. This is the equation. Yp prime, yp second. Now, sorry, I have inserted in the wrong equation. Yp prime of x equal 2hx plus k. Yp second of x equal 2h. Now we substitute into this equation. This is the equation. 3y second. Not the other is the previous exercise, sorry. 3y second, that is 3 to h, plus 4 y prime, that is 2h x plus k, equal 5x plus 7. That is 6h. No, let's write in order. 8hx plus 6h plus 4k equal 5x plus 7. 5x plus 7. So become, so this equation becomes, after we substitute y, this is y, y prime, y second. Do you recognize what we have obtained? Polynomial of first degree equal polynomial of first degree. And then we write coefficient of x, 8h in the left hand side, equal 5, coefficient of x in the right hand side, constant on the left, 6h plus 4k equal the constant, which is 7. Now we solve h equal 5 over 8. Now 6 times 5 over 8 plus 4k equals 7. That is 4k, sorry, equals 7 minus 30 over 8. From which we get 4k equal 7 minus, we simplify, 15 over 4. 4k equal 7 times 4 is 28 minus 15 is 13 over 4. That is k equal 13 over 4 times 4 is 16. K, H, and then the solution is y of x equal a only without one, e to zero is one, a plus b, e to negative a, here I write a only, e to zero x is one, a times one is a, plus b times e to negative 4 over 3x plus hx squared plus kx. H is plus 5 over 8, over 8 x squared plus kx plus 13 over 16x. Homogeneous solution, particular solution. Do always the verification. It would not be necessary, because but nevertheless it is a useful exercise. If we add, for example, before, at the end, after we have found the solutions of before, this was the equation, and the solution have you solved at the end? I don't remember. Well, maybe. Yeah, no. In the exercise of before, at the end, after we obtained this solution in the previous exercise, we have not calculated the A and B from the initial conditions. I leave it to you as an exercise. We choose y of zero is negative 2, y prime of 0 is 5. From this equation, this was the solution. Okay? You must impose these conditions to this equation. Okay? The previous exercise is left to you. Now, to conclude, where is the question? Yes, it's here. Here. We have four terms. A is solution. This is the homogeneous solution because A, let's consider A. A is a constant. First derivative and second derivative of the constant A is zero. 0 plus 0 equals 0, the homogeneous equation. B, e to negative 4 over 3x is solution of the homogeneous equation. 3y second plus 4y prime equals 0. These terms, this polynomial, we have the two terms, sorry. The homogeneous solution and the particular solution. The homogeneous solution consists in itself of two terms, but the particular solution cannot be divided. The whole polynomial will give 5x plus 7. Okay? The verification is very simple. Yp prime equal 5 over 4x plus 13 over 16. Yp second equal 5 over 4 only. Now, 3y second is 3 times 5 over 4 plus 4y prime. Plus 4y prime is 5 over 4x plus 13 over 16 equal, this must be equal to 5x plus 7. Let's verify. 4, here we simplify 4, 4, we get 5x. Now, 15 over 4 plus 15 over 4 plus, here we simplify 1 and 4 at the denominator. 13 over 4 equal 28 over 4 equal 7. Equal 5x is copied plus 28 over 7 equal 5x plus over 4. 28, 15 plus 13 over 4. But 28 over 4 is 7. That is 3y second plus 4y prime is effectively equal to 5x plus 7. This is the verification. Now we can add. This is the solution. We can add the Cauchy problem. We can add, for example, y of x equal 1, y of 0 equal 1, y prime of 0 equal 4, equal 2, sorry. And then y of 0, what is y of 0? First of all, let's compute y prime of x equal y prime. The constant gives 0. Here we have negative 4 over 3 b e to negative 4 over 3x plus 5 over 4x plus 13 over 16. Now, let's impose, let's compute y of zero. What is y of zero? This is y. If we put x equals zero, we get a plus b times one, a plus b plus zero plus zero, a plus b. This is y prime of zero is equal to negative 4 over 3b times 1 plus 0 plus 13 over 16 equal. This is y of 0 equal 1. This is y prime of 0 equal 2. Let's solve the system from the second equation. Negative 4 over 3b equal 2. But 2 is 32 over 16. This is 2. Minus 13 over 16. That is negative 4 over 3b equal 32 minus 13 is 19 over 16. And then b equal equation of first degree, negative 19 over 16, 19 times 3, 16 times 4, equal negative 57 over 64. This is B. A equal 1 minus B equal 1 minus B is plus 57 over 64 equal equal 64 plus 57 over 64 equal 11 1 and 1 then 6 plus 5 is 11 plus 1 12 over 64. This is A, and then the solution reads only, reads now reads y of x equal A is 121 over 64 plus B, that is plus minus 57 over 64. This is B. E to negative 4 over 3x plus 5 over 8 x squared plus 13 over 16 x. This is the solution satisfying the solution obtained from here with A and B. The solution satisfies the differential equation and then the boundary condition. Okay, I leave to you an exercise. Just a moment. Homework, as one says in English, homework. Y second. Minus 6 y prime. Plus 34 y equal, for example, equal 2 sin 5x. First homework. Second, y second minus 16 plus 16y equal 3 cosine of 4x. Okay. The last thing that I must say is this one. Is this. When we have the third case in the right hand side, even if we see only the sine, only the cosine, what you want, in both cases, the solution y of x is must be written this in this form: y prime y zero of x, homogeneous solution, and you already know what it means. Plus, the particular solution must be in the first case. We see sine of 5x, we copy sine of 5x, but we must always write both sine and cosine, even if we see only one, sine plus cosine of 5x, the same argument, and then h plus k. In this case, y of x equal homogeneous solution plus h sine of 4x plus k cosine of 4x. If this is the particular solution, if one term of the particular solution would be linearly dependent with one term of the homogeneous solution, you have to multiply the whole particular solution times x. If some term of the particular solution also after the multiplication by x is still similar with dependent with a term of the homogeneous solution, we multiply times another x, that is x squared. Okay, try to solve these exercises without initial conditions. The initial conditions are, we have seen, are very simple. It is only where it is in the last case. It is only a linear system, a very simple linear system in this last case. Do you see? We have solved this system. It is not a problem, the system. Try to solve by leaving, you leave you leave the arbitrary constants in the homogeneous solution without finding A and B. Okay, these are the two homeworks for you. Well, I break the record, otherwise it is too long.